is the result of the Where to Put Edward Heath statue competition. The winner was a Mr. Ivy North, who wins 10 guineas and a visit to the sailors' quarters. That was last year's reenactment of the Battle of Pearl Harbor, performed by the Batley Town Women's Guild. It was written, directed, and produced by Mrs. Rita Fairbanks.
Hello again.
And what are your ladies going to do for us this year?
Well, this year we decided to reenact something with a more modern flavor. We had considered a version of Michael Stewart's speech on Nigeria, and there were several votes on the committee for a staging of Herr Willy Brandt's visit to East Germany. But we settled instead for a dramatization of the first heart transplant. Incidentally, my sister Madge will be playing the plucky little Springbok pioneer, Dr. Christian Barnard.
Well, off we go then with the Batley Towns Women's Guild reenactment of the first heart transplant.
First heart transplant. But this is not the only open-air production here that has used the sea. Theatrical managers in this area have not been slow to appreciate the sea's tremendous dramatic value. And somewhere out in this bay is the first underwater production of Measure for Measure.
Yes, he would give me from this rank offense, so to offend him still. That's right, the time if I should do what I ought to name, or else I'll die.
Thanks, dear Isabel.
Very close here, you'll be back tomorrow.
When you would force it, sure, it is a sin. All of it.
The underwater version of Measure for Measure. And further out to sea, Hello Dolly is also doing good business. And over there on the oyster beds, Formula 2 car racing.
The armpits.
Number 21. The bottom two-thirds of the nape of the neck.
Number 22, the nipple.
And that concludes this week's episode of How to Recognize Different Parts of the Body, adapted for radio by Anne Hayden-Jones and her husband, Pip. And now we present the first episode of a new radio drama series, The Death of Mary, Queen of Scots. Part one, the beginning.
You are Mary, Queen of Scots?
I am.
Death of Mary, Queen of Scots, can be heard on Radio 4 almost immediately.
I think she's dead.
Episode 2 of The Death of Mary, Queen of Scots, adapted for the radio by Bernard Hollowood and Brian London. And now, Radio 4 will explode.
prison then?
Looks like a penguin.
No, I didn't mean what's on the television set. I meant what program?
Oh. I dream of Jeannie with a large brown hair.
It's funny, that penguin being there, isn't it? What's he doing there?
Standing!
I can see that!
If it lays an egg, it will fall down the back of the television set.
You'll have to watch that. Unless it's a male.
Oh, I never thought of that.
Yes. Looks fairly butch.
Perhaps it comes from next door.
Penguins don't come from next door, they come from the Antarctic! Burma! Why'd you say Burma?
I panicked.
Oh. Perhaps it's from the zoo.
Which zoo?
How should I know which zoo? I'm not Dr. Bloody Brunofsky!
How does Dr. Brunofsky know which zoo it came from?
He knows everything.
Oh, I wouldn't like that. It'd take the mystery out of life. Anyway, if it came from the zoo, it'd have property of the zoo stamped on it.
No, it wouldn't. They don't stamp animals property of the zoo. You couldn't stamp a huge lion.
They stamp them when they're small.
What happens when they molt?
Lions don't molt.
No, but penguins do. They run rings round you logically.
Oh, intercourse the penguin.
It's just gone 8 o'clock and time for the penguin on top of your television set to explode. It was an inspired guess. And now...
Number 23, the shin. Number 24, Reginald Maudling's shin. Number 25, the brain. Number 26, Margaret Thatcher's brain. And number 27, more naughty bits. Number 28... the naughty bits of the cabinet.